today, I'm here to tell you about the hidden treasures of the human body, the marvelous stem cells. Humans are the crowning glory of the nature, and during Renaissance times, it was thought that the architecture of the human body represents the architecture of the universe. This is a picture of Vitruvian Man by Leonardo da Vinci, showing the geometry of the human body. Renaissance period was the beginning of the modern medicine. The anatomy of the human body was discovered, and by the invention of the microscope, it was studied, the body was studied at the cellular level, and it was found that the cell is the smallest building block of the body. And we are composed of 50 trillion cells. A trillion is a number with 12 zeros. So how big would be the house of trillion zeros? So imagine a house of trillion building blocks. And in fact, the Great Wall of China is built of 4 billion building blocks. And we, as human beings, are 10,000 times more complicated than the Great Wall of China. And it took 2,000 years to build the Great Wall of China. And perhaps you wonder how long it takes to build a human being. In an average, it takes 7 to 10 minutes for mom and dad to put two magic building blocks together to lay the fundament of new life. And the rest of the bodybuilding is done by the magic stem cells. I was trying to imagine what would my life look like if I lived in Renaissance times. Despite of the great progress in science and culture, women were not allowed to study. So luckily for me, I live in the 21st century in Latvia, where society is familiar with gender mainstreaming ideas, and I am a researcher. So I chose to wear a lab coat instead of that gorgeous dress. I came to the research lab when I was a third-year biology student, and I was fascinated by the friendly atmosphere in the lab. Respectable scientists were sequencing DNA, and during the breaks, they boiled tea and smoked in the fume hood. Wow, I thought this could be my dream job. So now I have 19 years of experience being a researcher. And during the past 7 years, I've been studying adult stem cells. And I'm very excited about the stem cell potential. And I think that today we live in the golden era of stem cell discoveries. Every part of our body has some capacity to renew due to these amazing stem cells. And I want to understand the regeneration process that occurs naturally to find out ways how to use stem cells to treat diseases. How I got interested in cell biology? One day, I saw a picture in my high school biology book that looked something like this. I tried to reproduce it, and it described that cell consists of membrane, and there is Golgi complex, and mitochondria, and lysosomes, and there is nucleus, the director of the cell. So my vivid imagination pictured a large desk in the middle of the cell with a strict director giving commands. When I learned to use the microscope, I never saw a director inside the cell. Instead, I learned that cell is a very complex structure and nucleus is rather a hard disk that stores genetic programs. And cells communicate with each other by sending signals. And these signals are biological and chemical molecules. And the signals are transmitted then to the nucleus, and the genetic program is starting. So once we know the signals to make the desired cell type, we can grow cells in a petri dish and then transplant into the patient and treat the disease. Cell experiments are performed in cell culture laboratory, which is equipped with such equipment as sterile biosafety cabinets, incubators, microscopes, and different chemicals. And cells are grown in special plastic bottles in liquid cell culture medium. So during experiment, we add a mixture of growth factors, and then we observe changes in cell shape and protein expression. And in this image, I wish to show you one experiment that I managed to prove that adult stem cells are similar to embryonic stem cells in their potential. And when I tried to publish my observation, my paper was rejected 3 times, but I didn't give up. And now this paper is published and cited 115 times by other stem cell scientists. And here is a classical experiment to prove that you work with stem cells. So to prove that these are stem cells, you have to show that they're able to differentiate into 3 distinct cell types. So I add 3 different mixtures of growth factors, and as a result, after 3 weeks of experiment, I got fat cells. And I can say that these are fat cells because I can stain oil droplets in red. And then I get bone cells, and I can say that these are bone cells because I see calcium deposits stained in orange. And then the cartilage cells that I can stain blue. Well, experiments take a long time. And to get these results, it took me 1/2 year. One may wonder, what takes so long to get results in research? And now imagine that you want to prepare some very complicated dish, a very complicated recipe, something like homemade mayonnaise. So first, you have to get the recipe, then the right ingredients, and then you have to know the special technique, how to mix it together. And I tried 2 times, and I failed. Well, the same happens in experiments. It's the mixture of right ingredients and the technique that makes it work. And here, I'm showing you skin stem cells. It is the fluorescent microscopy image. And I use special dyes to color cells. So you see the director, the nucleus, stained in blue, and the mitochondria, the power plant of the cell, is stained in red, and cytoskeleton that holds the cell together and gives its shape is stained in green. I can spend hours looking into the microscope. It's like seeing a different world. And I think that these cells look like jewels. And indeed, stem cells are our inner treasures. Here is another experiment where I used a mixture of nerve growth factors to make skin stem cells to become nerve cells. And it took 2 years of work for my student Vadim's to establish the right procedure. And now we have a model system to find a drug that would stimulate nerve growth after trauma. And make a wild guess how long it will take for me to find this drug if it took 2 years to get to this picture. Breaking news fascinates humans nearly every day. We hear about restored vision, about improved heart functions, rebuilt urinary bladders, rebuilt trachea. A lot of studies have been done in a mouse model. By the way, during my PhD studies, I worked with thousands of mice, and I really worked very hard. And when I finished my PhD, I thought, that's it, no more mouse work. And then I got married. And now I study human adult stem cells. For 1,000 years, humans have been dreaming to reach the stars. And yet, we have come as far as to the moon. And for 1,000 years, people have been dreaming to find elixir of life. And we are making first steps in understanding how stem cells work to regenerate the body. And there is enough evidence now collected that stem cells from patient or from the donor really can cure the disease. And there is success in clinical trials to treat such diseases as retinal degeneration, to improve heart functions after heart attack, to stop transplant rejection, to renew cartilage, to heal skin lesions, and to treat blood cancer, autoimmune diseases like Crohn's disease, and immune system deficiencies. The road is long from stem cell research to the clinics. There are significant safety standards that must be met to say that the treatment will be safe for patients. And the main safety issues for stem cells are the potential tumorigenicity and immunogenicity risks. So I see great similarity between Renaissance era and the stem cell era. So both increased understanding about the human body with little effect on healthcare. And to increase the effect on healthcare, more specialists are needed in biotechnology, bioinformatics, bioengineers, healthcare, just to make the infrastructure in the field. And university is the incubator of knowledge generation. And I use this image, Earth at night, to illustrate that in each of the major light spots, there is a university. And in each of the universities, there is a cell culture lab and a stem cell scientist working on discoveries about stem cell use to treat diseases. I think there's a great potential in this field. And it takes a long time to educate a biotechnologist. So one learns how to use advanced research equipment and how to plan experiments and how to interpret the data. And in coming years, there will be major advancements in stem cell use, in bioimplants, drug screening, and stem cells will be uploaded with anti-cancer drugs like Trojan horses to reach the cancer and to destroy it. 23 years ago, a Nobel Prize was awarded for the discovery of bone marrow transplantation. And that marked the beginning of the golden era of regenerative medicine. And I believe that stem cell-based therapies will become the golden standard of healthcare for my children's generation. Thank you.